So children, now we'll be doing practice set 1.3. Practice set 1.3. But before looking at this practice set, we'll be learning some concepts of similarity. Say if there is a triangle A, B, C. There's another triangle. Say if this triangle is PQR. And both of these triangles, say if it has its sides in proportion, if the sides are in proportion, say if AB upon PQ is equals to BC upon QR, and this is in turn equals to say AC upon PR, okay, and say if the angles of these triangles are congruent, say if A is congruent to P, if B is congruent to Q, and if C is congruent to R. For any two triangle, if the sides are in proportion and if the angles are congruent, then the triangles are said to be similar. What are the triangles said to be similar? When the sides of any two triangles are in proportion and the angles are congruent. Say if all the three sides are in proportion, then the triangle is said to be congruent by SSS test. If two sides and one included angle is congruent, if two sides are in proportion and one included angle is congruent, then the triangles are similar by SAS test. And if only two angles are congruent, then the triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. This is what you have learnt in your standard 9th also. And that is why I have not explained you it in detail. So children, what you need to remember is that two triangles are said to be similar. Two triangles are said to be similar if their sides are in proportion and if their angles are congruent. But remember, there are certain tests of similarity. The first test of similarity is SSS test, then SAS test, then AA test of similarity. In SSS test, all three sides of both the triangles are in proportion. In SSS test, all three sides of both triangles are in proportion. In SAS test, two sides and one included angle is congruent. Like in this, say I have two triangles, I take ABC, I take PQR. And if I have taken like this, if AB upon PQ is equals to BC upon QR, along with this, what do I need? I need angle B congruent to angle Q. Because AB and BC ka angle B is what? The included angle. So angle B will be congruent to him. If this is the case, if two sides are in proportion and one included angle will be congruent, then the triangle will be said to be similar by SAS test of similarity. AA test. Any two angles are congruent. If any two angles are congruent, then the triangles are said to be similar. By which test? By AA test of similarity. This you have already learnt in your standard 9, and that is why I have not explained it in detail. Okay, children. Now we'll be doing practice set 1.3. For this, for in detail, you can refer page number 18, 17 and 16 of your textbook. Okay. So now we'll be doing practice set 1.3. Now look here, children. You've been given one figure. Now, children, the question is, state which two triangles are similar and by which test. So, what is my given here? My given is angle ABC equals to 75 degrees. Angle EDC is also equals to 75 degrees. So, I need to prove. What I need to prove? Which triangles are similar and the test of similarity. Okay, so proof. Children, see, if you look at triangle ABC and if you look at triangle EDC, you will find that angle B is congruent to angle D. And along with angle B and angle D, you have angle C, which is present in this big triangle also. And it is present in this small triangle also. That means angle C is a common angle for both the triangles, right? So I'll write in triangle ABC and triangle EDC. See, B corresponds to D because B and D are congruent. C should correspond to C because they are common side. So, I am naming the triangles as ABC and EDC. Okay, children? So, in triangle ABC and EDC, I have angle ABC congruent to angle EDC. And this is my given, or I can write each 75 degrees. Other than this, I have angle C. Angle C, say I am naming it for the bigger triangle. Say if I name it as ACB. ACB. Here what will be the name be? ECD. Okay, children. So ACB will be congruent to ECD. I'll write common angle. Right? So you have therefore triangle ABC will be similar to triangle EDC by a test of similarity. Okay, children, I hope that you would have understood this. So make a note of it. So now we'll be doing sum number 2. So in sum number 2, you have two figures. One is P, R, Q, wherein the values are given to you. The other one is A, C, B. The values are given to you as X and 8. This is the figure of sum number 3. Okay. So we'll be doing sum number 3 first. So these are the two triangles. Okay. So this is 6 and 4, X and 8. Okay. So what is given to you? See, there are two poles of height 8 meter and 4 meter. So this is one pole whose height is 4 meters. And there is another pole whose height is 8 meter. If the length of the shadow of the smaller pole due to sunlight is 6 meter. This is the smaller pole and say QR is the shadow and the shadow is 6 meter. Find the shadow of the bigger pole at the same time. Okay. So children, now have a look here. So here I'll be going with the solution directly. Okay. So here PR is the first pole, smaller pole. AC is the So I'll write down PR is the smaller pole. QR is its shadow. Okay? Then AC is the larger pole. BC is its shadow. Okay, now see, as the shadow is formed, at the same time, as the shadow is formed at the same time, you know that the pole and the shadow will always be perpendicular to each other. And whenever the shadow is formed at the same time, the angle made by the pole, this angle, will always be equal. So directly we'll write triangle PRQ will be similar to triangle ACB. Okay? So now, therefore, whenever two triangles are similar, their sides are in proportion, children. So PR upon AC will be equals to PR upon AC will be equals to RQ upon CB, which will in turn be equals to PQ upon AB. So I'll substitute the values here. So PR is 4 upon AC is 8, RQ is 6 and BC is X, and PQ and AB value is not given to you. So I'll write now, when I'll take only two ratios, 4 upon 8 is equals to 6 upon X, cross multiply, 4X will be equals to 6 into 8, X will be equals to 6 into 8 upon 4, X will be equal to 4, 2's are 8, so X will be equals to 12 meters. Therefore, the shadow of larger pole is how much? Is 6 meters, is 12 meters. Okay, children? So this is sum number 3. Now we'll be doing sum number 2. Okay, by mistake, I have drawn the figure, third figure, and so I continued with the third sum. Now we'll be doing this second sum, sum number 2. Okay, so what is given to you, me, is there are two triangles. Children, you will have to draw the figure always on this side of your notebook. Okay, so PQR, this is 6, this is 8, and this is 10. LMN is given to you as 3, 5, and 4. You need to state whether the triangle is similar and if by which test. So these are the values given to me. I'll do the solution directly. So in triangle PQR and triangle LMN. Okay. So in both of these triangles, I know that PQ is 6 and LM is 3. So I'll find the ratio of PQ and LM. 6 upon 3, that is 2 upon 1. I'll give this as number 1. Then I take QR and MN. QR upon MN equals to 8 upon 4, 2 upon 1. I give this as number 2. Then I take the ratio of PR and LN. 10 upon 5, that is 2 upon 1. So from 1, 2 and 3, I come to know that PQ upon LM is equals to QR upon MN is in turn equals to PR upon LN. And when all the three sides are in proportion, the triangles will be similar by SSS test of similarity. Okay, children, I hope that you have understood this. Now we'll be doing sum number 3. Children, you need to keep your textbooks with you. Okay. Now for sum number 3, draw the figure and write down the given and to prove part of your own. Always, whenever you watch the video, what you need to do? Once I start writing, drawing the figure, you need to draw it. And then what you need to do is you need to write the given and to prove of your own. Okay, children. So make an habit. So what will be my given here? My given will be in triangle ABC. I've been given that AP is perpendicular to BC. I've been given that BQ is perpendicular to AC. I've been given that BP and C are collinear. Then I've been given that AQ and C are collinear. And I need to prove. And one more thing. Again, I've been given that AP is 7 and BQ is 8 and BC is 12. Now, based on all these values, I need to prove that triangle CPA is similar to triangle CPQ. And I need to find the value of AC also. So here goes my proof along with my solution. Okay, so prove how I'll do. Which triangle? Triangle CPA. Now have a close look. Where is triangle CPA? CPA. In this triangle, one angle is 90 degree. CQR. CQ. So it's CQ, not R. It's CQB. Okay? CQB. In this also, one angle is 90 degree. See, both triangles have one angle 90 degree. And there is one more thing, that is angle C, which is common in both the triangles. Dekho, ye triangle CPA mein ek 90 degree aur angle C hai. Aur CQB mein ek 90 aur angle C hai. Theek hai? So I'll write in triangle CPA and triangle CQB. Okay? So in triangle CPA, what do I have? I have angle P. So say if I name angle CPA as 90 degree, then here angle CQB will be my 90 degree. So I'll write each 90 degrees. Then common angle, angle C. Say first triangle mein PCA I name. PCA. If I name this angle C as PCA, then here I will be naming it as QCB. Okay? So both angle common angle. So when in two triangles, when two angles are congruent, both the triangles will be similar by which test of similarity, children? By AA test of similarity. And you all know that whenever two triangles are similar, their sides are in proportion. So CP upon CQ. Kisse equal rahega? PA upon QB. Ye kisse equal rahega? CA upon CB. रीजन लिखना है CSST. ओके, और इसके पहले के भी सम में जो भी मैंने सीखा है उसमें भी ये रीजंस दे दो. इफ आई हैव फॉरगॉटन देन यू गिव द रीजंस. आर चिल्ड्रन, सो देखो साइड्स इन प्रोपोर्शन. अब वैल्यूज दिया है मेरे को. AP कितना दिया है? 7. CP का वैल्यू नहीं दिया है. CQ का वैल्यू भी नहीं दिया है. AP का वैल्यू 7 दिया है. BQ का वैल्यू 8 दिया है. CA ढूंढना है और CB का वैल्यू 12 दिया है. अब हम लेंगे व्हेन 7 अपॉन 8 इज इक्वल टू CA अपॉन 12. अब इसको तुम क्या करने का, क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करके सॉल्व करने का. क्या होएगा ये 7 इंटू 12 अपॉन 8 इक्वल्स टू CA. सो व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ CA? यू नीड टू सॉल्व. 4 टू जा 8, 4 थ्री जा 12. ओके, ये आ जाएगा 4 टू जा 8, 4 थ्री जा 12. तो ये कि 7 थ्री जा 21 अपॉन 2, दैट इज इक्वल्स टू. सो चिल्ड्रन ये हो जाएगा 10.5. ओके, सो दिस इज द सम. सो टुडे आई हैव डन सम नंबर 1, सम नंबर 2, सम नंबर 3 एंड सम नंबर 4 चिल्ड्रन. सो आई हैव टॉट यू 4 सम्स. तो आई वांट यू टू डू sum number 8 as your homework because it's very easy. Okay, sum number 8 has to be done as your homework, and in the next video I'll be teaching you 5, 6, 7 and 9. Okay.